Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Just a moment, you just soak up the lyrics. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. We thank you, our Lord. Father, we thank you, Jesus. Father, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord. Get your mind on the Lord. Let him know that we praise him. Lord, we praise you, oh Lord. Thank you for your presence being in our midst today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 Lord. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. He comes out on Sunday. He comes out on a Sunday of a Sunday. Woo! Glory! You are worthy, O Lord. You are worthy. How Lord. Woo! Come on now. Yeah, Lord Jesus. Yeah, Lord. Woo! Hallelujah, Father. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We want to give him what's due him. Amen. For he is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I know most of all know that I am a worshiper. Amen. I can get lost just in the worship. I can get lost just in the praise. Just being thankful for all that he have done for me and all that he is doing. I can get lost in the worship. I can get lost in the praise. For he is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. Thank you, Father. We're getting ready to share a message with you. Praise God. And the title of the message is Stay on the Potter's Wheel. Amen?
Amen.
Praise you, Lord Jesus. We want to stay on the Potter's Wheel. Amen. We want to keep the Holy Spirit spending everything that's in us that's not like God. We want to stay on the Potter's wheel so that the wheel can keep on turning and turning and turning in our lives, that we may be shaped and molded into his image. Yeah. In which he created us from the beginning of time. He created man in his own image. So that's what we want to talk about today. Staying on the Potter's wheel. Coming from the book of Jeremiah, the 18th chapter in the first verse. You can follow along with the Holy Bible, but I normally try to make it simple so you can understand the message. So the first verse, we're going to talk about Jeremiah for a minute. Now, Jeremiah, he was a man of peace. A man of peace. Praise God. He was called to prophesy strife and destruction in the year he saw the ruin of the kingdom of Judah. Coming to the first verse. The word of the Lord was given to Jeremiah by God. He told him to get up and make your way to the potter's house. Amen?
Amen.
So he woke Jeremiah and told him to go out, get up and make your way to the potter's house. Amen. My God, my God. He told Jeremiah, he said, I will cause thee to hear my word. with your spiritual ears, revealing a message to give to my people. So he was telling him, I will cause you to hear. Amen. Praise you, Lord Jesus. So when you come to a place to receive revelation of God's word and understanding, and if you are open to hear, he said, I will cause you to hear. I will cause you to receive the revelation and understanding of the message. I will reveal. I reveal unto you what I am saying to the church. Jeremiah. He said, My people sits in the house of prayer, hearing the word of God with their natural ears. In other words, not receiving understanding or revelation from the message. Praise God. How can you be born again without understanding of spiritual things, without the knowledge? Hallelujah, God. How would you even have a desire to be born again? Hallelujah, Jesus. Woo, hallelujah, Lord God. How in Jesus' name? The Bible says, in all you're getting, get understanding. Hallelujah. Now, we got to remember that Jeremiah was sent to the potter's house because God wanted to reveal something to Jeremiah, but God said that he will cause him to hear revelation and understanding. I'm going to show you how important it is in Hosea, the 4th chapter in the 6th verse. The word of the Lord says, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Because God has rejected knowledge. It's how important it is for you to find a place where you can receive the knowledge and understanding of the message that God is saying to the body of Christ. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I must read this again. In Hosea, the 4th chapter, the 6th verse. My peoples, the Lord is saying, my peoples, them that have been called by my name, my peoples are destroyed for a lack of knowledge because they have rejected knowledge. And he said, I will also reject thee. You will not be a priest to me. How can you be a priest to me if you don't have knowledge of me? Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of God, I will also forget your children. That's in the book of Hosea. Amen. So it's very important because if you don't have knowledge of God, you have no desire to know God, and you will not be able to be shaped and molded to his image because you have rejected the knowledge. You need to find you a potter's house. You need to find a place that you can receive knowledge with understanding and wisdom of the message that God has for the body of Christ. Where is your potter house? Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Where are you going to receive revelation and knowledge of who he is? Praise God. It's time to wake up Zion. Unclog your spiritual ears to hear what the Spirit is saying to you. You have no problem hearing and understanding everything else but the voice of the Lord. Amen. And the written word of God. And all you're getting, get understanding of who the Lord thy God is. Knowing that he is the creator of all things. And everything in the earth was created by him. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. The all-knowing God, the all-seeing God, the God of benefits, the God of healer, the God of the redeemer, the God of the one that will deliver you from the bondage and the assignment of the enemy. Get some understanding of your God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Praise God. He said, my people perish because they don't have understanding. God told Jeremiah, he said, I will cause you to hear. I like that. Because we can be so distracted. When we even come to the house of God, we can be distracted by anything. But it did not matter in this situation, but God is saying, I'm going to cause you to hear. Amen. I'm going to cause you to understand the message. Just find your what? Potter's house. Ikande. Find a place where they are speaking of me and the message to the body. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus. I will cause you to hear with understanding and revelation. Oh, Lord. Help us to know you. Help us to know you in the power of your written word. Not the philosophy and opinion of men, but help us to know you in the power of your written word. Amen. Guide us to the potter's house where you will cause us, praise you, Lord Jesus, to receive revelation and understanding of your word, like you did Jeremiah. Because we are serious about knowing who you are. We are serious about shape and mold into your image. Amen. So the instruction to Jeremiah was truly clear. It was clear as day to Jeremiah. God wanted to speak to him at the potter's house. Woo! Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. A place where revelation of whom God is revealed. A place where God causes you to hear the word with your spiritual ears. The word preacher under the anointing has your breaking power to challenge the heart of man. Praise you, Lord Jesus. You need the anointing. Hallelujah. But it is anointing that breaks yokes. It is anointing that set a man free. It is anointing that will cause a man to say, what must I do to be saved? Found in the potter's house. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus. The word preacher with the anointing is powerful. It penetrates the heart of man. Challenge him when he hears the word. The spirit moves inside of a man. He moves, halabasikande, because it is the word of God. It is a revelation and it's true. And it moves, ikanda, in the heart of man, giving man a desire to serve him and to know him in the power of his might. Amen. If your lifestyle, if he ain't moving inside of you, and if your lifestyle doesn't change, then your eternal destination remains the same. There must be a change. Amen. Amen. Whatsoever a man sow is what he reap. It's time to pray, Lord, speak to me like you spoke to Jeremiah. Direct me to the potter house where I can receive revelation of your word. Amen. The third verse. Jeremiah went to the potter's house. And look what he find at the potter's house. So Jeremiah got up, obeyed the voice of God, and he went to the potter's house. And this is what he saw. He saw the potter working, working on a wheel, a machine that smooths out the lumps of clay. Amen. So the potter's skill was to make objects out of clay with his hands. That's the potter's skill. He would make different types of vessels, and he would put them on a wheel to wheel out the lumps and the bumps in the vessel. Amen. And I want you to know that you are a vessel in the Vasikanda. Hallelujah. Because we was made from the clay, from the dust of the ground. God spoke to the dust in the name of Jesus. And he told the dust to create some eyes, create some head, create some arms, create some legs. And we was created from the dust out of the ground. Amen. We was the clay, molded and shaped in the eyes of the Lord, in his own vision of how he wanted man to look. Hallelujah. How he wanted man to be able to see, feel, and touch. All was created in that clay. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. He is the greatest potter. Amen. And we are clay in his hands. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. So this potter was working clay on the wheel. But the first vessel that he made was poor. He couldn't use it. It was just messed up because the clay had gotten too hard to be used. Amen? So he made it over. Amen. The first vessel he did not like. So the potter made it over. But he used that same clay by putting it on the wheel. The wheel is the part that wheel out the lumps. Praise you, Lord Jesus. So that he'd be able to shape this clay. And that would be, which would be pleasing in his eyes. So the first one was no good. So he reshaped it, that vessel. And the second one, it was pleasing in his eyes. That one was good. Now, here come the word from the Lord. Then the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah again, saying, O house of Israel, talking about the peoples of God, talking about us. O house of Israel, cannot I do with you this potter has done? Hallelujah. Can I not change my mind about what I see in you? Hallelujah. And put you back on the wheel? Hallelujah. Can I not do what this potter do? If I see something that I'm not pleased in you, I can take you, put you back on the wheel, and spit out everything that's in you that is not of me. I am the Lord thy God. I will place you back on the wheel and begin to spin that wheel, and every lock of sin, every lock of unbelief, every lock of doubt, I will spit it out. Hallelujah. But it is my desire to shape and mold you into a vessel that is honorable and pleasing in my sight. Can I not do what the potter has done? Amen. To Zion, to Israel? Can I not respin you if I'm not pleased in what I see in you? Amen, amen. Praise you, Lord Jesus. In other words, I will reshape you and mold you with that same clay that I made out of you from the beginning of time. A vessel of honor. Just stay on the potter's wheel. Amen? Church, as the clay, you are the clay. In the potter's hands, you are in God's hands, and he can fix whatever is broken. Woo, rumba. He can fix what the enemy has broken in your heart, broken in your life. For you are clay in his hands, and he owns owns the spinning wheel of life. Let him spin you again. Let him reshape you again. Get back on the potter's wheel.
Amen.
God has all power and authority over our life. God continue to work on our vessels, making us honorable and useful for his servant. Oh, our role is to repent before the clay hardens and our heart get hardened and we stay shaped and formed out of something that he cannot use. Don't let your clay get too hard. Don't let your heart get too hardened that God can't use you. Too many lumps, too many doubts, too many fears, too much unbelief. And God will not bust it loose unless you are willing to get on the wheel again. He would not force them lumps of sin, doubt, and unbelief out of you. You got to be willing to say, Lord, put me back on the wheel. Spin me again, oh God. I have fallen short of your glory. And I need this lump spit out of me that is dishonorable in your sight.
Yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. We must be willing vessels and understand the need to repent. Turn around. Change. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Change your ways and your behavior. What God is saying to us, I have power over your life. Amen?
Amen.
I have power over your life. Praise you, Lord Jesus. I'm getting a little warmer. So it's, I have power over your life. Amen?
Amen.
Just like the potter has control over the clay. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen?
To reshape it or destroy it. Or to get the lumps out of it. What is it that you want him to do? Wow. He have the power to destroy, get the lumps out of you. What is it that you will have him to do? Now, this is a humbling experience. It's very humbling. Letting, praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Like I said, praise God. A very, very humbling experience. A lot of times people don't like to humble themselves down. Amen?
Amen.
That's why I say to you, this is a very humbling experience, letting God impact our lives. Once again, our heartfelt words, repentance is all it takes to restart the process over again. That's all it takes to restart the process over again. He will place that same clay he made from the beginning back on the wheel and smooth it out again. The message to you is to stay. Listen to the message. To stay on the potter's wheel. Every time you fall short of his glory, ask for forgiveness, and the wheel will continue to spin the lumps of sin out of your life. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. Stay on the potter's wheel. How can I stay on the potter's wheel? By resisting the devil. Amen?
Amen.
The Bible said, resist the devil and he will flee.
Yes.
By not overriding your convictions. Amen. These are the things that help us to stay on the potter's wheel.
Amen.
by repenting and asking God for forgiveness and spin me all over again. Yes. Woo, rabbi. In Jesus' name, it is my desire to be spent, oh God. Spin me over again. If you find anything in me that is not like you. So God instructed Jeremiah. He told him to get up and go to the potter's house. He never questioned God about the place. Why? Because the place didn't matter if God was there. Amen? He didn't tell him to go to the church house. He told him to go to the potter house, and I will cause you to receive understanding and wisdom of the message.
Amen.
So we must learn how to hear and obey the voice of God.
Amen.
The word of the Lord says, my sheep hear my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. Jeremiah, a man that heard the voice of God and just obeyed it. Sometimes we just got to hear, don't question it, and obey it. If he leading you to do something that is righteous and that is good, don't question it. Just what?
Obey it.
Obey it. Amen, amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He was sent to the potter's house to receive a message to deliver to the peoples of God. And when he got there, he saw the potter's wheel. Hallelujah, Lord God. Being used for shaping and molding clay. Another question, where is your potter's house? The place where God causes you to receive understanding and revelation of his word. Your potter house may be in a basement where two or three are gathered in the name of Jesus. And during the gathering, his glory shows up, revealing truth to you. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord God. In Jesus' name, your potter house may be in a rundown church on the outside of the building. But when you get inside of the building, it is engulfed with the glory of God and signs and wonders following. Where is your potter house? Well, God calls you to hear and receive revelation of his word. A question. How do you get to spin? You know how the dancers and stuff spin around and they don't be dizzy? When they spin it, they get on, walk on off with a straight walk. So my question, how to get spinned on the potter's wheel without getting dizzy? Hallelujah. Something to think about. Hallelujah. The dancers, I read, they have a vocal point. They have to keep their eyes on a fixed point. Just like I'm looking at that clock. If I was being spent, if I'm a dancer and I'm going around and around and around, I have to keep my eyes on that clock. In order for me not to be dizzy. So that's how they just spin and spin and spin. And you say, wow, I would have been falling over or wobbling when I come off that wheel. But you need a fixed point to view while you spinning. So here my question is again. How to get spin on the potter's wheel without getting dizzy? By keeping your eyes locked on a fixed point. Amen. Keeping your eyes locked on Jesus is your fixed point. Hallelujah. If you can keep your eyes locked on Jesus, your fixed perked, you will not fall. Amen. When you get off that wheel, you will not be stumbling. You will not lose your balance of life in Christ. Walking around in darkness, repeating the same mistakes over and over again, in Jesus' name. So there is a way to fix, lock your eyes on Jesus, and you will keep on striving. You will keep on moving. You will keep on being shaped. You will keep on being molded in his image, and he will cause you to receive revelation. He will cause you to receive knowledge of who he is. Where is your powder house? In Jesus' name. You don't have to become dizzy when you're spinning on the wheel of Jesus. Amen. You don't have to stumble about in life wondering where you're going and how things are going to turn out. Why? Because your eyes is locked in with Jesus. Yes. Yes. And they can spin you all day long and you will not be dizzy. Because you're keeping your focus perked. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord Jesus. So no matter what is going on around you, lock your eyes on Jesus, the true power wheel. Jesus will not make you dizzy, stumbling, fumbling about in life. Don't know what move to make. Don't know where to go forward. Don't know where to go backwards. Because you spin out with the cares of this world. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Stay on the Potter's house. So the message today is to stay on the Potter's house. Don't let your clay become unusable. Amen?
Amen.
Don't let your heart be so hard that he can't use you. Amen? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus. That is my message today. To allow the Lord Jesus to cause you to hear. A place where revelation and understanding that you can know what the message is that Christ has for the body of Christ. Amen. You don't want to be in a place and you can't get understanding. You can't get revelation. You want to know what the message is. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you for the message today. We thank you for what you are doing. We thank you in the name of Jesus that we have a powder house and we welcome.